story about Beethoven and his deafness and the relationship between his deafness and the style of his composing. Beethoven had a particular sort of deafness which started out with cutting off high frequencies. So that's why we looked at the high notes in this course, and to focus on that we looked at his string quartets. Our hypothesis is that there would be a relationship between his deafness, which is well documented actually, and the number of high notes. And Edo did a job in counting all those high notes.
If you consider the string quartet individually, it's difficult to find the patterns, but if you consider them as group, as actually three different groups, these different use of high notes emerged.
Now this is one of the first times we encounter a high note in the first violin part, and that's exactly what our paper is all about high notes in the music of Beethoven's string quartets. It's nice to mention our co-author on this paper, which is Wim Saris from the University of Maastricht.
They suggest, well, then you should try to do something trying to relate statistics with this deafness, and that's how everything started. The second time we found the high notes in this quartet. It was composed between 1798 and 800, in the period where Beethoven first reported that he was having trouble in hearing sounds.
How is it to play such one of these early quartets? Can you give an example of how easy or difficult it is to play?
Well, technically there are some demanding places in it, so we can show you by playing one of the parts. You see there, the intonation is not perfect, so it's quite difficult. Okay.
His middle period was interesting because of his deafness kicking in. He used hearing aids, something like this, which is an ear trumpet actually. And he also used other kinds of devices to make sure that he could listen to his piano in a proper way. So this deafness has started to kick in the middle period.
Things to do here. I start the whole piece with a solo.
Yeah, and this actually,
and that's different from the early.
Yeah,
ones.
I mean, we have the really big part for the cello, which is not usual in the early works. The tone is much more lower, and the color of the music is much more somber. It has really a less use of high notes.
In the last period of his life, he was completely deaf. He got very angry actually at being deaf. You can imagine that as being a composer. And we thought that would be interesting to see whether that we could trace that back to the score again.
Again, we hit a high note, a very high note, and indeed what actually we found, there was an increase of the use of a high note, and together with a great freedom in the use of note and freedom in form also.
For me, I see it like first period is like going to have a walk on a hill, and here it's like climbing the Everest.
This music is beautiful, and what's especially interesting is how it played in his head, this music. And it has to do with the balance between the auditory feedback and the inner ear. He relied more and more on his inner ear, he had to, because he was deaf, and that made his music at that point in time much and much richer.
Maybe it gave him more freedom, because he was not attached anymore to the physical sound, but he just use his imagination.
Now, of course, we only looked at the string quartets now. We'd love to do also his piano pieces because they were also stretched in time, they're also in periods. So maybe also in the piano sonatas we can have the same type of pattern. So that will be a follow-up study of this one.
Yeah, follow-up. But okay. You are the piano player.
Yeah, I'm the piano player, that's right. But you do the analysis, that's okay.
Wagner pointed out that, in his opinion, the music of the last period was so great, not despite his deafness, but because he was deaf. And he called this music as a revelation from another world. Thank you.